Well, there's the access point for 14, but it's actually like 20-25k away from Dividing Lakes, so what we're going to do instead is we're going to take this lovely looking highway that goes into the woods that's called Dagger Lake Access Road. Hopefully this works, or I'll be, I don't know, late for work on Wednesday. Nearest to Algonquin Park office is like 2 hours away, so I called in the reservation and they were kind enough to just give me the permit number. A couple other things that we're going to try this trip. Number one, is it possible to solo an 18 and a half foot canoe? The trails are right, I thought, you know, it's a little rocky. I was feeling good about the CRV. And this is a Yaris. Yeah, and the reason the Yaris didn't make it is because there was a ditch with ground clearance issues. So, yeah, CRV, nice one. It's a beautiful day. And this is the proper trim for an 18 and a half foot canoe outfitted for a solo expedition. All the way up there is the backpack.
Paddling time. Whoops. So we're at the end of the Dagger Lake. Took about 25 minutes. I'm gonna try and find the portage, which is somewhere that way. As you come across, the wind's picking up from the west at the end of the lake as it builds up over the lake. So hopefully it's not too bad on the way back home. Let's play find the portage. I swear this was not staged. There it is, straight ahead. No snowmobiling. Well, it is tempting. The weather's right for it. Ugh. Check it out. Well, here we are at Minky, and the portage from Dagger Lake was an interesting experience. Turns out the Mark 220, well, it wasn't marked, I guess the 220 on Jeff's map, totally dried creek bed. It wasn't dry creek bed, it was a creek bed with a creek. So I had to go around, and thankfully I did see some other footsteps and footprints because it's been raining this year. And instead we went into the, instead of the west arm of Minky, went into the north arm of Minky Lake there. So that's where we are after about a good 1200 meter portage. A little sweaty. So there's the canoe wedged between the two trees there. That's nice of the trees, I think. 800 and something meters to go. I just passed the fork. Another 1600, I guess, to go. 95 minutes. 2500 meters. One wrong turn to whatnot for about 100 meters. So it's really a 2700 meter portage. Pretty proud of myself right now. Single carried. And the reward is this lovely, lovely view. And I'm gonna make me some soup right now at the portage. Because I like soup. And I like the end of portages. And there are no bugs. And I'm tired.